let's look at some more sequence operations. Python sequences have more behavior than just length and element selection. They can also be tested for membership and be sliced. So membership uses the in or not in operators. If I make a list of digits and then I ask if 2 is in those digits, it will tell me that that is true. And this is a built-in operator in the language. Now 1828 is not in digits because only 1, 8, and 2 are in there. If I ask whether 8 is in digits, I will get true. It doesn't matter that it's in there twice. Slicing allows you to create new sequences that are only parts of the original one. So if I take digits, which is 1828, and I slice it using this operator, which looks a lot like the element selection operator, but instead has a colon in the middle, then what I get back is a new list that has some of the elements, but not all. Now the convention is that these are indices and they have the same meaning as a range, where the starting index is inclusive and the ending index is exclusive. So by going from index 0 to index 2, I'm getting 0 and 1, but not 2. Okay, so slicing from 0 to 2 gives me 1 and 8. If I slice from 1 on, then I get everything except for the 0th element. I get the first, the second, and the third. And if by leaving out this ending index, I could just go all the way to the end. Slicing creates a new object, which means in an environment diagram, if I wrote the list literal and bound it to digits, and then I picked out the start, middle, and end, where the start is everything up to index 1, so that will be only the 0th element. The middle is from 1 to 3, and the end is from 2 on, then I'll get the following diagram, where digits is a list, start is a different list containing 1, middle is a different list from that containing 8 and 2, and end goes from the element at index 2 all the way to the end. Now notice that these have their own indices. So index 0 of this list is index 2 of that list. They're the same number, but they're different lists. So one thing we can do with slicing is transform trees. So let's say we wanted to put a restriction on the structure of a tree. A binary tree is either a leaf or a sequence containing at most 2 binary trees. So not 2 any trees, but 2 binary trees is a restriction that makes sure that every subtree anywhere down inside the tree has only 2 branches or fewer. And the process of transforming a tree into a binary tree is called binarization, and it shows up in various places in computer science. So here's a function that takes in any old tree and returns a binary tree. So here's a tree that's really flat. It's got 7 branches and they're all leaves. So the way that we've binarized this is to have the leaf 1 be 1 branch and the other branch contain all of the other leaves, but in such a way that no tree here has more than 2 branches. Now, how did we get from here to here? Well, if the tree's a leaf, we just return the tree. There's no binarization needed. But if the length of the tree is greater than 2, meaning it's a sequence of trees and there's more than 2 branches, then we need to get down to just 2 branches. And we do that by saying I'm going to build a new tree where the 2 branches are the 0th branch and a tree that I create which has all first branch on branches as its branches. So that gives me this 1, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, all in a separate tree. Now so this is all but the first branch are grouped together into a new branch. Now, we're not done. We also have to recursively call write binarize on both of these branches. So we know at this point that tree is bound to something with 2 or fewer branches, but we don't know whether somewhere in the tree there may be more branches for some subtree. And so by recursively calling write binarize, and which then recursively calls write binarize, we make sure that we get a nested structure like this at the end of the day. So let's try that out. I'll quickly rewrite write binarize. Which first checks for the base case that the tree is a leaf. If so, it returns the tree. Otherwise, if the number of branches in the tree is greater than 2, that's a problem. So I want a new tree that consists of the 0th branch, and then using the slice operator, I get all the other branches in a separate branch. And then I can return what I get by write binarizing each branch for B in tree. Now I need a tree. I'm going to show you something called a pangram. You've probably seen it before. It's a sentence in English which contains all the letters in English. The quick brown fox. Okay, let's break it up a little bit. In the two sublists, jumps over a lazy dog. So this is a tree of strings that has 2 branches, but those branches are not binary. In fact, this one has 4 branches and this one has 5 branches. So I broke it up in this way just to show you that the recursion really matters. So it is a tree with only 2 branches already. So if I compute the length of this pangram, it will tell me it's only 2. But the problem is that the branch 0 has too many branches itself. So if I call write binarize on the pangram, then I get a new structure where I have the quick brown fox nested so that brown and fox are in a branch, and then quick is in a branch with that branch, and then the is in a branch with that. And then I have a separate branch with jumps over a lazy dog. So part of computer science that I work on is called natural language processing, and we actually try to figure out the structure of sentences. Now, we don't do it just by calling write binarize, because that doesn't always tell us the correct structure. But we do build systems that have the specific purpose of generating a tree that tells you the structure of a sentence. And so this is the Berkeley Parser. If you search the web, you can find it yourself. And if I click parse and pass in the quick brown fox jumps over a lazy dog, it then gives me the best guess for its tree structure. And these different symbols tell you what kinds of words and phrases are used in the tree. And you see that it's found a noun phrase over here, the quick brown fox, and then a verb phrase jumps over a lazy dog.